In this video, I'm going to show how to install Visual Studio Community Edition 2022. The first step is to open up your favorite browser and go to your favorite search engine and search for Visual Studio Community Edition and then 2022. Look for the visualstudio.microsoft.com link and click on that. And you should see a Download Visual Studio button. Click on this and you'll save the setup file. I'll save it to my desktop here. And now run the installer. First thing is it gets the latest version of the Visual Studio installer installed on your computer. And now you can select which features of Visual Studio you want to install. For me, I'm going to select ASP.NET and web development. This installs some things so I can create websites. If you want to do work with Azure, you would select the Azure development. I'm not going to do that here for this particular example, but that's something that may be useful. If you want mobile development, you might check this one. I'm going to check .NET desktop development, since that's what I tend to do. And if you want to install Unity, you can check game development with Unity. I'm not going to do that in this case, so I'm going to leave that unchecked. There are some other things down here. I like data storage and processing since I do a lot of work with SQL Server, so I'm going to check that. And that's it for the main workloads. If you notice down here at the lower right, it says the total space required, 9.95 gigabytes. I also want to install some additional components. So I'm going to go into the individual components section. And this is where you can install different versions of .NET and different features. Currently, this will install .NET Framework 4.72, 4.8, and .NET 6. If you want to, you may also want to do the .NET 5 runtime in case you're working with some .NET 5 projects, and you may want the .NET Core 3.1 runtime. I'm going to uncheck this, so I'm just going to do the .NET Framework 4.8 and .NET 6, since that's what I tend to develop in. And I like to have both of these because some of my projects, my older ones, are in .NET Framework, so I need to have this .NET Framework 4.8 SDK, the software development kit. If we scroll down and look at some other things, we can install some specific Azure tools. I don't need those. We can install some code tools. I don't think there's anything in here other than Git for Windows that I want. So this will make it a little bit easier to work with GitHub. We can install some compiler build tools and runtimes. I don't need anything from here. Some additional debugging, development tools. I do want ASP.NET MVC 4. This is good for some of the web services that I may have out there. You can also install Node.js development tools and Python development tools. Again, that's not something I use, so I'm not going to check those, but they may be useful for you. Here's where you can install some features for Unity and Unreal Engine. And I think that's it for me. If I look down here, the total space required is 10.28 gigabytes, and I'm going to have install while downloading and just click the install button. And that will take a few minutes while Visual Studio installs. Once the installer is finished, you'll have the option to sign into Visual Studio. If you have a Microsoft account, you can sign in here, you can create a new one, or you can say not now, maybe later. I'm just going to select that for this video. You can select your development settings. I choose Visual C Sharp since that's what I work in, although you could choose JavaScript, Visual Basic, any other option here. And personally, I like the dark mode, so I'm going to leave it at dark mode, but you could select the blue color scheme, blue extra contrast, light, or the system settings. And then I'll start Visual Studio. Now, something to be aware of when you create a new project in Visual Studio. So if I click on Create a New Project, I get a list of the different types of projects here. Something, if you're new to Visual Studio, something you really need to pay attention to is that you are picking the correct form of .NET. So let's say I want to create a WPF, a Windows Presentation Foundation program, a desktop application in C Sharp. I would go to the All Languages, click C Sharp, and in my search for templates, I'm going to type WPF. Now, if you notice, there is a WPF application up here that says a project for creating a .NET WPF application, and then you also have WPF app .NET framework, Windows Presentation Foundation client application, and you've got some other projects in here. It's important that you pick the correct project. So if you're building a .NET framework WPF project, you need to pick this project type here that says WPF app .NET framework. If you're building a .NET Core, .NET 5, or .NET 6 WPF program, you need to pick this one up here that just says WPF application. This is very important because if you add multiple projects, so for example, if I'm looking for class library projects in C Sharp, you cannot mix and match the different versions of .NET. There are a couple versions you can mix and match, but generally you can't. So if I have a solution that contains a WPF project and a class library project, they both have to be .NET, or they both have to be .NET framework. So make sure when you add your projects that you're selecting the correct type of .NET. And I'm going to close this down since I'm not actually going to create a project in this video. One more thing to be aware of is as you're using Visual Studio, about every month or so, you might see a message that says there's an update to Visual Studio. If you see that, you can run the installer, and you can do that by just typing in Visual Studio installer. That will bring up this application again, and you'll have another option here that says install updates. So you can just run that. It will install whatever the updates are for Visual Studio, and you'll have the latest version. That's it for how to install Visual Studio Community Edition 2022. If you have any questions, please leave them below the video or on the support page, and I will get back to you as soon as possible.